So I had a few seniors in my college who attended NC State. And then one of their batchmates was going to NC State as well. So they helped me connect with the guy who was going to NC State with me. And then we formed a WhatsApp group and we approached people on Facebook. There are many areas actually. So one's Champion Court, one's Kensington Apartments, the other's Government Crossings. And these are the main ones where most of the students stay. There's also Avery Close. But yeah, these are places where most students stay. There are also a few more places, but they're not that popular with Indian students. Just look at every single point in your lease agreement and yeah, that's what I'd say. I mean, apart from that, I mean, there's always a date on which you have to pay your rent. Otherwise, you will get a legal notice straight away. There's no, they won't remind you. So be sure to make sure that you know that date and when you have to absolutely pay the rent by. Individual rent for the room was $350 every month. And apart from that, as you mentioned, transport was close to zero because I was using the university transportation system. Food was, I would say, another majority, around $200 a month or so. Another $200 for including everything, like that included electricity, water, mobile phone and internet. So all together, I would say it was like around $200 every month. I wouldn't say I felt any homesickness or any culture shock. It was mostly what I expected over there. So not any homesickness or anything. How did I manage food and other essentials? Again, there are lots of Indians staying in and around you, so you just go and ask them. Everyone's pretty helpful with new students. I would say we've reached a week before the orientation because you have to get everything done. So you have to firstly get a bank account. You have to get everything in your name. You have to get electricity in your name, water bills. You have to get a Wi-Fi router and stuff like that. So I'd say 1 week is more than enough. They tell you all the little things to do when you're in school. Most of it, they also tell you about plagiarism, which not many from India know. Before going to the US, they tell you what to do, what not to do. All the finer details like your class credits, how many hours you have to attend to be a full-time student. In my branch, they were I would say 60% people of outside the US and 40% US citizens. 50% were came directly like me with no experience from India, but the other 50% had some amount of experience. I went to basketball games, I went to football games, like the American football games. I also attended some sort of events here and there. But I did not have time specifically. I would have to make time.